It's been over 2 years since I first uploaded my conversion of the Grand Prix 1979 R-Factor mod to Automobilista, and I can proudly say with this new update, this is a product that I, and hopefully you guys, will be super happy with. Released in 2006 by Grand Prix Classics, the Grand Prix 1979 mod is considered one of the greatest R-Factor mods ever, but I didn't have the greatest experience with it. Due to this, over the next couple of years, I devoted a lot of my time to try to make this mod super fun to play, and this is the result. 30 cars, 15 tracks, this is Formula One in 1979. Before I start, I just have to give a huge shout out to Vintage Motorsport on YouTube. Without him, this update would not be possible. To showcase this mod, I've decided to race at Dijon Pernoy, host of the French Grand Prix, driving as Gilles Villeneuve. Here in 1979, Villeneuve and Reni Arnoux had one of the greatest battles in F1 history. So in memory of Gilles and this awesome moment, this is the setup I've chosen. We are at the 1979 French Grand Prix. Turning 26th in the Ferrari. Lights out and away we go. Get a great jump on the rest of the field. Another pass, quite a few cars. Down towards T1 as we lock up. Was using the brakes a little too hard there. Already making up 8 positions by the first corner. They are going to take a lot of weird lines of this course, so you just have to keep that in mind as duck under the shadow here. Shadow almost came back on the track, hit the McLaren there. I lock up and hit. Oh, we got the Renault sideways. Going to bunch up the field. Throwing a couple cars. Wolf Peke Rosberg in front of us. Shadow's gonna dive bomb us. I just got dive bombed by the AI. We're able to retain the position on the Shadow. Running the final turn. These guys really like to slow down before the final corner. So we just swoop around the inside of the Wolf. That is one lap completed. Chaotic first lap as we already made up half the field. Break at the 150 meter board. We got Emerson Fittipaldi in front of us. Through the first sector, we're able to gain a lot of time because the AI make a lot of weird moves and decisions. Through the second and third sectors, they regain that time back. Just got to find the best time to overtake. There's not many spots here. As long as you can get a run on somebody. Come down. Towards the back end of the lap as we were able to duck underneath Emerson Fittipaldi, still alongside of us. We were able to complete the move, however. So we were able to come around and make up another place on Fittipaldi there. Next up is the Renaults. Sorry, excuse me. Next up is the Brabham and the two Renaults. I'm gonna try to catch up to this pack. Overtaking Fittipaldi. gotta see. We got a big train of cars ahead of us. So, got some work to do to overtake this group here. Lot closer this time onto the front straightaway. See if we can outpace the Brabham. I don't know if we're going to be able to. That thing is a bullet in a straight line. Is they're gaining on both those Renaults up there. But it's not enough, but we do dive down the inside of the Brabham. If we can make the move stick, and we can. I didn't even see that one coming. That's just kind of where the car went. And down now to where the track splits. So we head to the left towards the Parabolique. Nice and early for this one. Don't want to get sent one up the inside. Both the John Pierre is ahead of me. Battling it out for ninth place. Try to get one or both on this next straight. So one of them really jab. We really not really checked up, but we were able to get. They run into the first corner and nicely done. He checked up in the middle of the corner, probably second guess he was going to run on the road or something, but you know their position done. You see we got a nice scrap for 7th up there with Niki Lauda. Our new and the other Jean-Pierre. Rotating position, see if I can pounce. Those coupe cars, they really slow down. Ooh. They break, man. It really comes out of nowhere. I was able to stick one down the inside. These two are side by side. They're going to slow each other down. But here, the Brabham is going to have the speed. I'm going to have to duck back inside. The Brabham is going to... Will he retain the position? I don't know, but... Renault will outpace him into the first corner. So I'll need to duck down inside as well. Lauda's not going to fight that one too hard. I mean, the setup... Going to be more realistic. 5 laps to go. Villeneuve and Arnoux are coming back together. Maybe we can, but this time the roles are reversed. Arnoux's ahead as I slid pretty wide there as Arnoux's going pretty quick. Holder on the outside. Let's see if we can get a run on the runner. I think we're going to be too far back. We only got 4 laps to go. Runner really thrives on the outside of Villeroy as we gain all the time back. First sector, almost a second quicker than my best lap. We're also really gaining on
that is. Hero and Lotus up there. Now to the backhand of the lap. We were much closer to the rental this time. We'll be able to try to make a move. We'll definitely have the slipstream here. Here we come now. See if we can get move, send one down the inside. He breaks much later, able to retain the position, but we are still getting much needed ground. We are also catching Reutemann and Pironi. Oh, we almost lose it. Coming off the back end of the parabolic. To the final corner. Rattles really going slowly over the throw on the outside. Who is going to get the run down toward the first corner? It looks like the Renault is going to prevail on that. But I will have the slipstream. Try this once again. Two laps remaining. We send one down the inside. We're able to get one. Get the position enough into seventh place. One position away from points. Try to get to points. That'd be pretty remarkable starting from last. I think someone's... Maybe that's just me. I thought someone was puffing up some smoke up there. Nope, I think I'm right. One of the cars is definitely having an engine problem. I cannot tell who it is. Maybe Andretti up ahead. Here we come around in the final corner for the final lap. We're able to get the run on the Tyrrell. He's going to have the slipstream from ahead, but we might be able to take it right back. He flies on the inside, but we will have the inside line. Will we be able to retain the position? Still side by side with the Tyrrell. So he's finally able to power on the outside, but we take it right back away. And this time we cement ourselves ahead. Can we gain any more positions? Someone is having an engine problem in front of us. Maybe they will. It will stop before. Come back to the start line. Maybe we can also get Reutemann before the start finish line too. That's looking a bit dire with only a couple corners to go. Rounding the final corner, it looks like Clay Recasoni is going to rack up the win. But can we get the Lotus here? Just one corner to go. It doesn't look like it. We're going to fall just short of getting fifth place. But last the points, we will take those any day. So that is the new and improved 1979 F1 mod for Automobilista 1. Definitely try it out. It's awesome to race in. And this is late 3 years in the making. Link is in description. Go try it out for yourself. And until next time, I'll see you in the next video.
Peace.